Nowadays, it is extremely hard to find a surf fishing rod that's going to suit all your needs. How do you pick one? There's a vast array of rods out there, starting from 20 bucks, the Okuma Longitude, the Boone's Farm of surf fishing, all the way to $500, $1,000. But in the middle lies a very special rod, a rod that has been used for many years. What if I told you that for $160, you can get one of the best surf fishing rods out there, one of the lightest, with some of the best top-notch components that you only see in $200 plus rods. What rod is this? I got a hold of this rod, and I'm going to do a very detailed review. Could this possibly be the best surf fishing rod in the market? It's probably definitely the lightest out there. But before we continue, if you're new to my channel and you want to be elite all year round, you want some of the best reviews out there when it comes to rods, gear, anything, please click on the subscribe button and hit the bell notification for some of the crispiest videos out here. The Bass Pro Shop Ocean Master Surf Rod is one of the best surf rods you could ever get, especially for the money. You see, I've used plenty of surf rods out there. I've used so many rods. Gone through Daiwa, Pen, you name it, I've used it. The Breakaway HDXs. But nothing beats the Ocean Master Surf Rod. For $160, you are getting a whole lot of bang for your buck. I've been waiting for this rod for years. And you know, the reason I say that is because I've been calling Bass Pro for years already. And I've been asking, you know, when are y'all gonna modernize y'all's Ocean Masters? You know, there's all these rods coming out with new technology, new guides, better reel seats, lighter. Y'all are a little behind. What's going on? Sure enough, they came through and they modernized it. Better than before. It is lighter. I could say it's probably half the weight of the previous Ocean Master. Although it doesn't look as good, it definitely has better components. It's keeping up with all the high-end rods out there. The next step up is the Pen Carnage. $50 more, you get the same components. One of the things that I've liked about the Ocean Masters are their accurate ratings. See, a lot of the rods are very overrated. Some will say that you can cast 4 to 8 ounces. In reality, max, you're casting 4 ounces. 5 ounces, you're pushing it. 8 ounces, you're breaking it. The Airwave Elite is that way. But the Ocean Master stays true to the rating, which is one of my favorite things about it. Well, here we are at San Luis Pass, the beachside of Galveston. And we got this new rod in the mail. The new Ocean Master. We use so many Ocean Masters. I love Ocean Masters. Like literally, these are like the best rods you could ever get under $500. You are not gonna find any rod with these components, these actions, under $220. But this is even so light. It's crazy like how light these are. These are a lot lighter than the previous Ocean Masters. They have a carbon coil technology. But right now we're gonna cast this out. We're gonna put on a Daiwa BG on it. We're gonna cut this off. We'll get to it. I also got this like 2 months ago. I got this for myself for Christmas and I haven't really used it. I think this is gonna be a great combo straight up. This is probably the best budget combo you can get that's mid-range with top-notch accessories and everything. You want the good stuff? This is it right here. Look at this. Beautiful setup. Stickers and all, look at that. This is the 10-foot, the 4 to 8 ounces. A lot of rods say that they could cast 6 to 8 ounces. But they don't. A lot of the Daiwas, they're rated 3 to 10 ounces. No way, those are noodles. They need Viagra. Oh my God. Wow. This thing bombs.
One thing that I was able to notice about this rod is it loaded nicely, it recovered quickly. It added a noticeable spring-like power to the cast, which gave it more distance.
Here we go, we got a crab on here now. Let's see how well it casts this. We're casting around 7 ounces right here. So I'm gonna check my bait. So this is a great opportunity to check how much power this rod has to pull out a weight out of the sand through current. Let's check it out. Yep, it's handling pretty good. Wow. This rod definitely has some power. Cause I'm pretty sure I'm reeling in a bunch of seaweed also. There we go. And this is a great spot to test out this rod because San Luis Pass is the deadliest surf fishing spot.
in the Gulf Coast, in my opinion, definitely the deadliest in Texas. There is so much current that runs through here, definitely has the power to reel in a giant fish. One of the things that I'm really liking about this rod is the weight. This thing is so light. I can't believe it. I can't believe they were able to make such a surf rod so light, but so powerful. And it has a lot of backbone. Like I said, this is the 48 ounce Ocean Master, the 10 foot. So here we're casting around 8 ounces right here. This is rated 48 ounces. All right, see it? There's a strip right there of current. Perfect, right there. Right on the spot, man. That's bullseye like a motherfucker.
So now I've finished casting this rod. I really like its responsiveness. It has a nice bend throughout the rod, and it's definitely casting within its ratings also. So now let's look at the next most important aspect of the surf rod, the components. Believe it or not, a lot of rod companies fail to place quality components on their rods. Any rod under $150, I'd like to say about 70-80% of those rods do not have quality Fuji components. The components that the Ocean Master has are components that only rods that are over $200 have. The rod itself employs carbon coil technology, double helix, a combination of glass and graphite, which lowers weight and gives it its strength. The Ocean Master employs Fuji K-Series guides, tangle-free alkanite ring inserts. Those are top-notch guides. And of course, it also employs a Fuji reel seat. All these components are extremely important and critical for any surf rod. Now, the casting version of this rod has the same blank, just different guides. They're still Fuji guides though. Now the Ocean Master, the surf spinning, has a 9-foot version, 1 to 3 ounces. That thing is probably a jetty monster. If you're gonna be fishing jetties, that's what you need right there. It's especially great for lures. The spinning and the casting do have their 8-in baiters, the 12 footers. Overall, I'm extremely pleased with this rod. I love the quality, I love the components. I love how light it is and how powerful it is. In my opinion, this is definitely the best rod, or at least one of the best rods under $500. It's definitely the best rod under $300 for sure. These rods range from $160 to $190, the more expensive ones being the 8-in baiters. But even at that price, you are not going to find an 8-in baiter under $200, especially with these components and the actions. And who cares if it's a store brand? Do you think the fish care if you have a Harrington 552? No. Let me tell you this, Aldi's had a rosé wine, an $8 wine, that was rated among the best in the world by wine aficionados. They said it was one of the best wines they've ever tasted. This was a store brand wine. That's the Ocean Master for you. Côte de Provence Rosé. And they determined this by listening to the wine. Well, that's it for my Ocean Master review. I really like this rod. I am very impressed. If you're in the market for a new rod, consider this rod. It definitely has the most bang for your buck. Well, if you like this video, like, comment, subscribe. You disagree? Let me know in the comments. If you know another comparable rod, let me know in the comments. I want to check it out. I'm a gear junkie, just like everybody. I love doing reviews. I love comparing and contrasting all kinds of stuff. I hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching.